impoverished family making below $20,000 a year all our lives, moving from shack to shack, hut to hut. House never had proper laundry, never was really clean or renovated for our comfort, but we put up with it. And as a child, I looked around at my peers and I saw that they were in pain. I looked around at my peers and I saw that they were impoverished as well. And I saw a lack of knowledge within all of them. And I remember a lack of knowledge within myself. I didn't know that it wasn't normal to not have food in the house. I didn't know it was not normal to have clean water, not have clean water. I didn't know it was not normal to be able to afford clothing in school. And so now, as an adult, as a scientist, I just got my degree in physics, for all of you that don't know. As a scientist, and as an activist in the community who has seen some of the injustice in my city and the other cities, I have to say something.
That's right.
Because if I don't, who will?
That's right.
You will. No, but if I don't, 90% of the college students that I went to school with couldn't do it. They weren't willing to skip classes. They weren't willing to sit out. They weren't willing to put forward their voices for the people. So I saw a need to be able to. I was given an opportunity to speak at community forums on stuff that I researched, stuff that I saw on social media. I was willing to run from class all the way to downtown to attend events where I could raise money for education, for children who needed notebooks and pencils and backpacks.
Yeah.
I was willing to walk the distance. I participated in a protest against Mike Pence at the University of Notre Dame about a year ago. This was also the day before I started research at Notre Dame. And I remember, as it was coming to an end, as the graduates had already come to us, they asked us, are we going to go inside? And people were scared, right? They didn't want to get in trouble. They weren't willing to put forward that next foot. What was that saying y'all said? One step forward, what was it? Now one step back, say it.
Forward together.
Now one step back.
Forward together.
Now one step back.
Forward together.
Now one step back. So we put our foot forward. We went in. And the first people, the police officers came after us. We had some signs with some sticks on them. And it was just, you can't have that. You can't have that. You got to carry your sign like this. Meanwhile, the graduates are in front of us with sticks below. Understand? And so we went in and we marched, and they led our march away from the students that were graduating, but we marched nonetheless. After that, I realized I had to do something more. And so we started to go to school board meetings to see what they had to offer our children who were being disenfranchised. In the year 2014 to 2015, South Bend, African Americans in the South Bay Community Schools missed about 2 million to 4 million minutes of class. A large percentage of these students, of the African American students, who don't count up to even half of the students in the South Bay School Corporations who get suspended. They accounted for most of the suspensions, most of the expulsions. These kids are getting sent home disproportionately. Not for actually smoking, not for throwing stuff, not for fights, but for relationship issues between them and the teachers. And I talk to these students. I say, young man, what's the problem? Why are you getting sent out of these classes? He told me because they don't like us. They're annoyed with us. They're irritated with us. I'm like, well, what's your proof? He's like, okay. So me and another white friend of mine were sitting in class, and we said to each other, let's do this little experiment, this social experiment. And that's all right. I said, all right, keep going. He said, you get in trouble for having your headphones in your class. That's all right. Okay, what's your point? He said, well, we both decided to put our headphones in the classroom. I said, okay, then what happened? He said, they sent me out, but not the white student. I said, why not? He said, because she didn't like me. And when he said that, I heard, because she was racist. Because she was part of the system that was oppressing disenfranchised children in South Bend. And I knew I had to do something. And so I fought against policies. I raised money for the kids. I spoke to the kids whenever I could, even if it cost me. I had a 2.6 GPA in my last semester of college. I had stopped going to class and started to write papers, write speeches, get in contact with people to come and talk to the kids. And I was also the president of Black Student Union, and I asked the Black Student Unions to come with me. And although they cared, they knew that they had to pay attention to their education first. And so I said, that's understandable. You paid money for these classes. But me, I can't sit by. I can't sit idly by and watch as our children are pushed into a pipeline leading them straight to the grave, to drug dealership, to unemployment, to ecological devastation in the prison. Uh-huh. I can't sit by. And to the very end, he offered nothing but kind words to me. We had a chance to speak with one of the freedom riders at northwest side of South Bend on the radio station. They had an opportunity to talk on the radio about relationships, toxic relationships in high school. They had an opportunity to rally with me downtown to fight against gun violence. And when the year ended, I had no more meetings to go to, when I was getting ready for exams, I received a letter at an award ceremony for our clubs and organizations. And they told me, thank you, Alexis. Thank you for putting in the time. Thank you for giving the consistency that we so needed in the school system. Thank you for raising us to a higher standard. Thank you for putting that extra foot forward, not one step back.
All right.
Right? And tears were flooding my eyes. I couldn't think straight. Because I realized that I wish I had that as well.
That's right.
I wish somebody was willing to put their education on the line.
That's right.
And so I gave it to them. Chances are they're gonna give it to other children. How many children are looking for somebody?
That's right.
To help them, to be consistent with them, to be real with them, yeah. To let them know what they're gonna face after they get out of high school. How many? Right. That's what I've been working on. And yeah. So I'm here today to put my body on the line. Yeah. Woo! I'm here today to put my reputation on the line. I have a job interview tomorrow, so what? I get another one.
Yeah.
But these kids won't get another chance.
Yeah.
These kids that are being poisoned by the lead won't get another chance.
That's right. That's right.
The lead and the blood levels are rising every day. There hasn't been clean water in Flint in 4 years.
That's right.
This is more important. What was it? Profit of people.
That's right.
People, right?
Yeah.